attractive.
Should we whisper it together?
It's race week.
Woohoo!
It's like MTV Cribs, this, isn't it? A bit excited.
On a scale of 1 to 1,000, how tired do I look?
I have to fight back the tears if I'm honest.
Debut weekend in British touring cars. Never thought I'd say that, to be honest. But here we are. Can't wait. So those of you that don't know, to race a touring car, you have to have a certain amount of mileage under your belt. I obviously did the motor-based test at the end of last year, but I didn't quite get enough mileage. So we're at Donington today to just top it up and make sure that everyone's happy for me to be out on circuit this weekend. So gonna go meet the team. They've been working super busy all week. And from what I hear, my car is all liveried up in my logos with my name on it and everything like that. So I am off to go and see my very own British touring car. Check out how I'm starting the day. Premier in. Woohoo! Let's go. Time to get ready. So, greasy here at Donington. British weather is definitely back. So it's gonna be a steady morning in that sense. Just gonna run through the processes of, you know, radio comms, certain little British touring car rules. So little things like when to have your lights on, when not to have your lights on, you're not allowed to use them in the pit lane. Obviously radio comms with my engineer and that sort of stuff. So yeah, it's gonna be a busy day, but because we're so close to the race weekend itself, it's very much a processes kind of day. It's not to go and set the world alight. We obviously want to see where we're at, see how we're getting on, but the focus isn't obviously optimum lap time. It's more so that when we get to Silverstone, we feel more confident. The team knows my driving style, knows my capabilities, and I know the team, I know the engineers, that sort of stuff. So I'm gonna get myself ready now. I've literally got race kit coming out my ears, making sure I've got enough for the weekend. But yeah, looking forward to it. Gonna get dressed and then we'll show you the touring car. Here she is. So as you can see, some sponsors on there that are recognisable from the last few seasons. So we've got PHSC, Spectra, obviously the usual Karma, and then there's just stickers everywhere. So far so good, big grin on my face. Driving the car is, you watch them on the TV all the time and you think, oh, it's a big touring car, but when you jump in it, you just turn into racing driver mode and it's back to business as usual. So first time on track since 2019. Obviously with COVID, it's been fairly difficult to go on circuit. So this is actually my first time driving a racing car all year. So loving every second of it and enjoying the day so far. 9:25, it's Thursday evening, and I am packaging and sending out, or getting ready to send out, Jade hats. So whilst other drivers are sat chilling out, having a cup of tea, I'm sat here on my own, putting addresses on packaging and sending hats out. But 40 hats sold in just a few hours, so I can't be happier. Thank you so much to everyone buying them. Really positive day with Power Maxed. Enjoyed working with the guys. Really learnt a huge amount. Obviously I drove the car with motor base, or drove a car at the end of last year, but I didn't do nearly as many laps as I did today. So today was a real foundation for the weekend and got me to grips with the car and what's to be expected. So really happy with how it went. It'll be interesting, but I've got a good team around me. I've got good support. You guys have been messaging and showing your support throughout today. What's funny is that everyone's messaging today, so saying I'll get the message in before the weekend when it gets hectic. Everyone's doing the same thing, so my phone's been pretty busy today, but I can't complain. I've had unreal support, and I'm loving every second of it. I just hope that the on-track stuff can be as successful as the rest of it, really. The build-up's been brilliant. I've got, obviously, Jade merchandise going out. I've got a new race suit for the weekend. I've been given a brilliant RV by the guys at Champion. So everyone's doing their bit and we're trying our best to make it a really positive weekend. So now we just need the actual driving side of things and the race results to come and walk away with big smiles on our faces. So I'm going to crack on with my hat packaging and then I'll see you guys tomorrow for an RV tour and some more footage of the car in the garage and shakedown. So another busy day. Night all! So, nice sunny Silverstone. Absolutely freezing. Got a bunch of layers on. It's really windy. However, my little video for you today is actually my motorhome. It's like a trailer. Can we take a look inside? It's like MTV Cribs, this, isn't it? A bit excited. Does that mean I have to show my fridge? There's not much in there. Look at this. Proper party pad. Jade hat station. I've been doing packaging up. We've got hats ready to go, some still there. And then bedroom one. I've used this as race kit room, so this is going to be a mess by Sunday. Couple of beds. Again, I've got no one here, so I can't share the experience with anyone. But Champion RV have done a champion job at providing me the best digs in the paddock, I think, for one weekend only. Okay guys, we are almost ready for shakedown. So that's half an hour on track. Obviously normally touring car teams would do that in the week leading up to the event, but because we are on back-to-back events, we do that at the circuit. So the car's all ready, as you can see. I need to check if my seats actually arrived, because I've got the guys from Indy Seats have done a mega job. So hopefully it's arrived. Nope, still not here. So we've got half an hour to go before we head out on track for half an hour on the circuit, just to make sure everything's working correctly. Dad, how was it watching me in the touring car for the first time?
Yeah, very special moment. Had to fight back the tears, if I'm honest. It's been a long time coming, but I was really proud of you.
He's more emotional than me.
Yeah, big smiles all round. Still lots of time to find, but that's, you know, that's the nature of the game.
Silverstone this weekend.
Guys,
Jonathan Park's been there this afternoon watching final preparations.
I think being a female in motorsport is still fairly unique. There's still not many of us.
Guys, this is the start of the weekend officially. It's going to be a busy couple of days. I'll try and check in as much as I can, but for now, it's time to get on track. So FP1 is done. We've got little Willow here, it's my niece. Hiya, say hello. Can you wave? No, I don't want to wave to you. And then we have the nutcases. Let's turn the camera around. Social distanced gathering in the motorhome. Mum's on the cups of teas, so the clan have started to arrive. And the weekend is fully underway. Say hi, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
There's positives and negatives to take from it. Obviously, as a competitive driver, there is some frustration with me, but overall, I mean, it's my first session in the car, on the grid with all these guys. I'm not a million miles away and we are improving. So I've still got a big smile on my face, even though you can't see it. And I've always raced better than I qualify. So tomorrow is where we're gonna enjoy it. Managed to get the thing off the line, which is the thing I was probably most worried about, because there's obviously a procedure to getting these things away. Overall, I'm really, really pleased, and yeah, a welcome to touring cars, I think. This has hopefully put me on that platform to show that I can be competitive and I can race well in this championship. So if we can carry on that momentum, hopefully between now and the start of next season, I'll have a deal in place and I can join the grid for a full year.